So Bethany Bauer, a 13-year-old girl, wants to ban plastic bags. Obviously, probably influenced by her environmental science teacher at her local school that has no real idea the scope of banning plastic bags does. Let me explain to you, Bethany, how plastic bags work. This is the evil, terrible plastic bag banned in Hawaii and Los Angeles. This is the most recyclable piece of item you probably have in your entire house. This is one of the best options for low-income families to replace things such as trash bags or any other type of bag that they need for short amount of time. I use these almost all the time. Now let's look at the alternatives. We can go back to the paper bag, and these are still used at a lot of convenience stores, but there's many problems with it. First off, it's not as recyclable. Second off, the material used to make it it's a finite resource. It's not like petroleum, which is easy. And, you know, petroleum, I could produce thousands of these and have no issue. These are made by trees. Trees are a limited resource, and they're also an expensive resource, driving up the costs that, you know, grocery stores have to charge for their food. So grocery stores that use these often have more expensive food. And it has nothing to do with actual food itself or the quality. It's probably the same exact food. But the prices are higher because the material they use to distribute it costs so much more. And anyone who used a paper bag in their entire life, you put a gallon of milk or something in there, and these handles, they won't last. You know, put three or four plastic bags over it, and you should be fine. Or let's look at the other alternative, the one that's championed in Los Angeles. These bags. Now, these bags are quite big, aren't they? Well, they're quite big, and you probably aren't going to want to keep it in your car unless you go to the grocery store every day. Otherwise, it's kind of taking up space, isn't it? They're not really disposable. If you, spill something in there, it's pretty difficult to clean. So I'm probably going to have to throw it out. And what will that do to the environment when a bunch of these bags that aren't disposable, they aren't recyclable, and they're made of material that's very questionable? What if these go into the environment? They're not like plastic bags where the hot New Mexico sun will just disintegrate them within a couple of days. If you ever seen a plastic bag left outside for a couple of days, it becomes almost dust in this very hot, intense weather. And, you know, we're not like Hawaii that has a fairly humid weather that would not dry these up and make them crumble. You see, in Hawaii, the reason they're banned is because they're a tourist site and they need to keep up appearances. New Mexico is not a tourist site, so we don't really need to keep up appearances as much. And our weather pretty much disposes of these pretty quickly, the ones that don't get recycled. Unlike Hawaii and California, where the humid weather keeps them up and intact. These, however, aren't a hot New Mexican sun, could probably not disintegrate easily. And the major problem with these is that you need one for every food type. This is for cold and frozen food. I'd need one for meat, I'd need one for different objects, and I would have to separate them by bag. You see, with plastic bags, that's pretty easy to do because they're extremely cheap and easy to make and recyclable. And that'd be easy to do with paper bags too, because even though they're more expensive, you're not gonna miss them once you're done with them. These are very expensive to keep doing, and you're gonna need a lot of them, and they take up a lot of space, and you're gonna probably have to keep them in your car because, you know, there's probably not enough room for them to keep them in your house, and you have to zip them up to keep the cold and frozen foods from being heated up. Because, you see the material in there will heat up in the sun. So if you don't zip it up, you'll just end up melting your food. There's many problems with these bags. They're expensive, they're big, they're bulky. You'll need at least 5 or 6 of them when going to the store. You'll probably have to keep them in your cars at all times. These bags are, for the consumer, relatively the best thing out there. They're cheap, they're disposable, they also can be reused many times for many things. I pick up dog crap with these. I pick weeds and put them in the bag, make them easier than, you know, very expensive and very worse trash bags that can't be, they aren't biodegradable at all. They can't be destroyed at all in comparison. So, you know, these plastic bags have many uses. I also, when I'm going on a short vacation, I don't use a suitcase. I just get a couple plastic bags and throw my clothes in there. Paper bags, I really don't even know what to do with them. I usually just throw them away. There's no real use for them. Anything I put in them, the handles are just going to break. So the plastic bag is the most reliable solution for poor and low-income families. And getting rid of it will drive up the costs of everything, just as they are in Hawaii and just as what's happening in Los Angeles. Look at the price of food in Los Angeles. Look at the price of drinks in Los Angeles. Look at the price of everything in both Hawaii and California. Ask yourself, can you afford all these bans and regulations?